Have your seat. There is one good news. So there's another Myanmar lady sitting in front here. No, Mumu Luen, her name. So she showed me the map download. No? So internet. So now they have put up many of my books, and also many of my teaching. No? My teaching there. So only the Dhamma download. No? You can download it. No? And you can read the books, and you can also listen to the Abhidhamma teaching, and also Visuddhimagga teaching, and also some Dhamma talk. So, no, good news for you. If you want, you can study and listen. So we have to continue. Now about the 16 Rupa Brahma realms. So let's read together. So we say, no, they situated much, much higher than the six sensuous blissful realms. So there are three planes of the first jhana. No? So the three planes of the first jhana are these three. So they are Brahma Parisajja. Now, Brahma Parisajja means the realm of Brahma's retinues. And Brahma Purohita is the realm of Brahma ministers. And Mahabrahma, the realm of great Brahmas. So, this is the Mahabrahma. So, among these, they are the most powerful. Not the most powerful. They are minister and they are retinue, they say. And the same thing with the three planes of second jhana are so paritabha. Parita means slight or minor, So the heaven of minor luster and apamanabha. The heaven of infinite luster. No? Apamana means infinite. So they have body rays, very infinite body rays. And then Abhasara, the heaven of radiant gods. And three planes of the jhana. So what are they? Please read. Parita Supa, the heaven of gods of minor aura, and Apamana Supa, the heaven of the gods of infinite aura, and Supa Kena, the heaven of the gods full of steady aura. And then we have the seven planes of food jhana, So the Vihapala, the heaven of the gods of great rewards. Asanya Sata, the heaven of Brahmas with just body and no mind. Suddhavasa, the heaven of pure abode, only anagami, no non-returners, and arahats are found in these abodes. Suddhavasa is made up of five planes. Avijha, the durable heaven. Atapa, the serene heaven. Suddhasa, the beautiful heaven. Suddhasi, the clear-sighted heaven. And Akanita, the supreme heaven. So we have already read the four immaterial realms. So we have already read them. So we can not just stop here. And like in the examination, Abhidhamma examination, they say, what are the realms? where only not the noble persons exist. So there are these, not the, these five Suddhavasa realm. Not only not Rupa Brahma, the noble person. So those anagami, non-returners, who attain not the fifth jhana, when they die, they are born in this realm. In this realm. And in this realm, not the anagami, they attain the higher mega, that is Arhata mega, and then Arhata phala, they become arahats, and then they pass over to Nibbana. So what are the realms where no noble person exists? What are the, those realms? So all the woeful boats, all the woeful boats, and this Asanya Sadda Brahma realm. No, Asanya Sadda Brahma. No, they have only bodies, no mind. So they cannot undertake any meditation. So they will remain just as the walling Brahma. Okay, so we have some more to read. So the next topic. Oh, we come to here. Is that all right? So we still have idea. There are person, the person in the not all these realms. So here. So persons in various realms. So not just in the chapter 4, we have seen about 4 persons. About 12 persons. So now we are going to locate those 12 persons in these in the various realms. So the 12 types of persons, Pugala, have been mentioned just before the conclusion of chapter 4. We shall now place or locate this person in the various planes of existence to which they belong. So in the 4 woeful abodes, only woeful, rootless person, we call Dugati Ahituka Pukala. They are found or they exist. They exist only. So we have only one type of person in woeful abodes. And in the human realm and Chitu Maharajika realm, remember then the lowest the celestial realm is Chitu Maharajika realm. And they have their lower members born in the earth. We say earthbound deities. So these two realms. So in the human realm and Chitu Maharajika realm, 11 types of persons, with the exception of the woeful rootless person, are present. So these woeful rootless persons they exist only in the woeful abodes, not in the human realm and Chitu Maharajika realm. And they have all the remaining 11 types of person. So 11 types of person. So do you remember the 11 types of person? If you don't remember, so we have to go back. The end of chapter 4. The end of chapter 4. Just ahead of this. Just go. No, 12 types of person. Not yet. Okay, go. Here. These are the 12 types of person. So the first type are the woeful, rootless person. They are woeful person, they are. So we have blissful, rootless person. Rootless person, those who are retarded, deformed, and blind, born blind, something like that. They have very low wisdom. So we call them the blissful, rootless person. They are born in the blissful realm, like we say in human realm and the Chitu Maharajika realm. They are born in blissful realm, but they are rootless, so very low wisdom. And then we have 2 rooted person and 3 rooted person. So these are the wallings, Puthujana. And remember, in the, you know, the human realm and the Chaturmaharajika realm, we can get noble person, all the eight types of noble person. No, so all these four part person and four prusian person. So 8 + 3, we get 11 person here. No, and then we go to do the five, no, the five, the higher realms, no, the celestial realm, the five higher celestial realm. They don't have this person also. They don't have the blissful rootless person. So these two types of person are absent, but they have these 10 types of person. No, 10 types of person. No, remember when the Buddha, no, the preach Abhidhamma in celestial realm. No, the 4,000 million Brahmas and celestial beings become enlightened as noble person. So they, no, so as, no, they have very long life. So these noble person, no, are still, no, they are residing in the, no, also in the celestial realm and Brahma realms. So we get 10 types. And then when we go to the Brahma realm, no? So you can lower a little bit. So, no? So with there are 16 Rupa Brahma realm, remember? So, no, with the exception of this, no, Asanya Satta realm, who has only body, and the five Suddhavasa realm, no, except this 6 realm, the remaining in the 10 remaining realms. So they have this 9 types of person. No, 9 types of person. Remember, to become Brahma, you must be 3-rooted. 2-rooted person cannot develop jhana, so they cannot, no, be born in Brahma realm. So we have, no, 3-rooted person as volumes, and then we have 4-part person and also 4-fruition person. No? And then in the, no, the Asanya Satta realm, no, they have only bodies, they have no mind. So we say only one type of person there. What would be that person? Rootless? No, as they have no mind, no root. So we say also they are called, no, blissful rootless person. No, blissful rootless person. No, these are the Asanya Satta Brahma realm. And in these, no, the five Suddhavasa. Suddhavasa means pure land, not pure land actually here, this one, no? No, so the five pure realm, we say, no, only 3 types of noble person. So we call anagami, non-returners, and then arhata mega, no, arhata part person, and then arhats, no, arhats, only 3 types of person here. So, no, those, the anagami means non-returners, and those who also attain the fifth rupa jhana. No, when they die, they are born in this, no, the Suddhavasa realm. No, they are born here. And then, no, here, they will attain the higher mega, that is Arhata mega. So we say Arhata mega person also exists. And then Arhats, no, exist here. Okay, I think that's finished the, no, the location of all living beings in the 12, no, 12 realms, finished now. So we go to the next topic. So in your book, what is the next topic? So we try to get to that. 4 modes of rebirth, is correct? So now, now, quite interesting about the 4 modes of rebirth. So what are they? Apaya, Patisanti, woeful rebirth. And then the name of the chaita, no, the name of the rebirth consciousness is Akusala Vipaka, Upika Sandirana, Ahetuka Chaita. So I think you have to show the Chaita chart number 1. Chaita chart number 1. So remember, among the 19 rebirth consciousness, no, they include this, the Upika Sandina Chaita. So this one, no, it is immoral, resultant. So we call them akusala vipaka upika sandirana citta. No? So rootless, resultant, no, upika means neutral, no, neutral, associated with neutral feeling. And then sandirana citta. No, this citta is, so we say it is the rebirth of, no, rebirth consciousness. Apaya prisanti means woeful rebirth or rebirth, no, the consciousness is this one. And then we go to number two, kama sukati patisanti. So kama is, no, the sense fear actually. So sense fear, blissful rebirth. Or we use here sensuous, blissful rebirth. So it is this consciousness. So now the name of the citta you have to give, no, the, from here to get the full name. Ahetuka, rootless. So kusala, moral. No, vipaka, resultant. And what is the name? Upika sandirana citta. So we give you the name here. No, kama sukati. Ahetuka prisanti. So kama sukati means, no, the sense fear, blissful, rootless consciousness. So what is that the name? Kusala vipaka, no? So here kusala vipaka. So it's better to put in ahetuka also. No, because it's rootless. Ahetuka kusala vipaka upika sandirana. Ahiduka citta. So he put ahiduka here. No, so you can put ahiduka here or you can put, no, in the front. So we get this consciousness as the rebirth consciousness of, no, this the sense fear, you know, blissful rebirth person. No, they are retarded person, remember? No, who are born deaf, dumb and blind, no, etc. And now so they try to make the kama prisanti. No, kama prisanti is the eight mahavipaka citta and then the two upika sanina citta also belong to sense sphere. So this ten, no, so they so among them, no, the kama sukati ahituka prisanti, rootless consciousness is this citta. And then second B is kama sukati sahituka, no, with roots. This is ahituka without roots. So here sahituka prisanti is eight mahavipaka citta. No, eight mahavipaka citta. So no, those two rooted person and three rooted person are born with this eight mahavipaka citta. So now the human beings and celestial being, no, so we are born with this eight mahavipaka citta. The three rooted person would be reborn with the mahavipaka jnana samyutta citta. And two rooted person will be born with mahavipaka jnana vibhuta citta. No, four each, no, four consciousness each. So these are, we call ten, no, the sense fear rebirth. Ten sense fear rebirth. Now this is, no, the next one is we call rupa prisanti, rebirth in the rupa plane. So they are rupa vajra vipaka chaita, no, this five rupa vajra vipaka chaita. So five rupa vajra vipaka chaita plus jivita navaka kalapa. Rupa prisanti, and that is for the asanya santa brahma. Remember, there is one asanya santa brahma who has only body, who have only body. So they are born with this, no, the material group. We call jivita navaka kalapa, and that is called rupa prisanti, but, no, the material rebirth. So altogether six, no, rebirth, no, in for Rupa Brahma Ram. And for Arupa Brahma Ram, there will be this four Arupa, no, the Vipaka Chaita. So Arupa Prisanti, rebirth in Arupa planes are Arupa Vajra, four arupa vajra vipaka chaita. No, so you should know this rebirth consciousness. No, in part dream, so you already know from here actually. So the notes. No, so one apaya parisanti. No, so vopo rebirth. And then one kama sugati, so this one kama sugati, patisanti, and then we have the eight, no, the kama sugati, ahiduga patisanti, no, eight kama sugati, ahiduga patisanti, so this ten, no, we are called ten kama patisanti, rebirth in the sense sphere realm. And then we have five rupa vajra, so this one, five rupa vajra vipaka chaita, and jivita navaka kalapa rupa, this one, no, prisanti, together make up six rupa brahma realms. Now five rebirth consciousness and the rupa material rebirth, so all together six rebirth, not six types of rebirth. And then for this one, so, no, and then we just try to add up together. So this will be included here. So how many we get altogether? Now we say 10 kama prisanti, 6 rupa prisanti, and this 4 arupa prisanti. Altogether, there are 20 types of prisanti rebirth. Now the number of prisanti, this rebirth, exceeds the number of rebirth consciousness by one, because there is one rupa prisanti. So we say there are 19 rebirth consciousnesses, remember, 2 + 8, 10, and 5 and 4, 9, 19 rebirth consciousness. But we have 20 types of prisanti. Why? So we have, instead of 19 rebirth consciousness, we have also one rupa prisanti. Okay, now we go to the next topic. Persons and rebirth consciousness. So how about this person? What would be their rebirth consciousness? So just try to connect. No? They are not very difficult. So we read again. The four apaya person in Nidia, not that hell, in hells. And Tirichana is animals. Pita, Vopo, Ghost, and Asura Ram, no, are born with Akusala, Vipaka, Upika, Sandirana, Ahituka, Chaita. No, this Chaita. No, they are all born with this, no, rebirth consciousness. So, number two. So in the human realm and Chatu Maharajika realm, no, in these two realms, degraded human beings such as those who are born blind, deaf, dumb, retarded, or deformed by birth, and degraded earthbound deities, no, or devas, are born with Kusala Vipaka Upika Sandirana Ahiduka Chaita, that is this consciousness. No, they are born with this consciousness. Those, no, the retarded human beings and the deva. And number three, in all the seven sensuous blissful realms, so no, those the one human realm and six celestial realms. So we call them seven sensuous blissful realms. So normal human being. So these are retarded human beings, so normal human beings and normal deities, no, or devas, are born with any one of the eight Mahakusala, Mahavipaka, Chaita. Thus, the eight Mahavipaka, Chaita acts as rebirth consciousness, life continuum, and then that consciousness of everywhere in the blissful sense sphere. And then among the Arupa Brahma. So among the Rupa Brahmas, the Brahmas in the three first jhana plane are born with Rupa, Vajra, first jhana, Vipaka, Chaita. So if they attain the first jhana, no, they will be born in this first jhana plane. And then number two, the Brahmas of the three second jhana planes are born with either Rupa Vajra second jhana Vipaka Chaita or Rupa Vajra third jhana Vipaka Chaita. So you can show the Bhumi chart number six. So now you can also see the chart in your book. So now we describe the rebirth consciousness in this column. No? In this column. So we say the three first jhana Brahma, no? Rupa Brahma. They are born with first Rupa Jhana. No? Rupa Jhana Vipaka Chaita. And the second jhana plane Brahma. They are born with second jhana Vipaka Chaita as well as third jhana Vipaka Chaita. And the third jhana plane Brahmas, they are born with fourth jhana Vipaka Chaita. And the seven planes of the fourth jhana realms, they are born with fifth jhana Vipaka Chaita. So the reason, the name of the Brahma realm and the rebirth consciousness. No? So here we have that jhana realm, but the rebirth consciousness is fourth jhana Vipaka Chaita. And for second jhana, plain Brahmas, they are born with not only with second jhana Vipaka Chaita, but also with three third jhana Vipaka Chaita. So the reason is, we describe the rebirth consciousness according to the five jhana method. And the planes, the name of the planes are given according to the four jhana method. So now we give you the comparison. So here, so below that we get it. So please go. We have a table. So the method of day being Rupa, Rupa plane. So we just show the table. So we go to the table here. So this table shows the two ways of naming the Rupa Jhana. Dual method of counting Rupa Vajra Jhana. So the jhana factors are described here. This is five jhana method. This four jhana method. And then this is the name of Rupa plane, Rupa Brahma realms. So we say, if we have all the five jhana factors, vitaka, vichara, piti, sukha, ikagada, we call it the first jhana in the five jhana method. We also call it the first jhana in four jhana method. And when these people die, they are born in the first jhana Rupa plane. This is the name of Rupa plane. Also is called the first jhana plane. So here we have no difference here. Now when you eliminate vitaka, so there are only four jhana factors, vichara, piti, sukha, ekada, we call it second jhana in the five jhana method. And in the four jhana method, we don't get that jhana. No jhana. And no jhana plane, the name of no jhana plane for this. Now we eliminate vichara again. So now you have only piti, sukha, ekada. You call it the third jhana in the five jhana method. And we call it the second jhana in the four jhana method, because in the four jhana method, after you attain the first jhana, we eliminate vitaka vichara simultaneously. So if you eliminate vitaka vichara, you have only three jhana factors. So we call it second jhana in the four jhana method. And the name of jhana plane is given according to the fourth jhana method, so we call it second jhana plane. And then you eliminate the piti again. If you eliminate piti, only sukha ekagra remain. And we call it the fourth jhana in the five jhana method. But we go to the jhana in the four jhana method, and the name of rupa plane is also given according to the four jhana method, so it's called tadjhana plane. And then if you elevate sukha, we get upikha ikagada, and that is called the fifth jhana in the five jhana method, fourth jhana in the four jhana method, and then it's also again it's called four jhana, the plane, four jhana rupa plane. So, the name of rupa plane. So now you can see those who attain the first jhana in the five jhana method, they will be reborn in the first jhana realm, first jhana rupa plane. And then those who attain the fourth jhana, they don't have any special plane for them. And then they attain the third jhana. So these two types of person, they are born in the second jhana, second jhana plane. So we say here, so when you come to the first jhana, so only they are born with first jhana, vipaka, citta. And then for the second jhana plane, those who attain the second jhana, vipaka, citta, and also that jhana, vipaka, citta, they are born, these are the neighbor, they are rebirth consciousness actually. So who attain the second jhana, their rebirth consciousness would be second jhana vipaka chaita. Those who attain the third jhana, their rebirth consciousness is third jhana vipaka chaita. So they, so these two types, they are born in the second jhana plane. And if you attain the fourth jhana, you will be born in the third jhana plane. And when you attain the fifth jhana, you are born in the fourth jhana plane. So that's why we have here, in the third jhana plane, rebirth consciousness is fourth jhana vipaka chaita. And for the seven, the planes of fourth jhana, so we call them fourth jhana plane, these are seven of them. Remember, we have asanya sadda brahma, we have pla, and five suddhavasa ram. So these people, instead of with the exception of asanya sadda ram, they are born with fifth jhana vipaka chaita, all these brahma, six brahma. So the asanya sadda brahma ram are born with what are they born with? The jivita rupa, jivita navaka kalapa, jivita navaka kalapa. So here already, so they are born where? Jivita navaka kalapa, they are born with this material group. Okay, so we finish with the four types of planes now, I think. So we can go to the third category now. So what would be the next topic? Oh, we still have the lifespan. Yes. Yes, this is the asanyata brahma. So again, that it is also the power of the mind. So this brahma, they can develop the fifth jhana, in the human realm. So they can develop the fifth jhana, and then they don't want to have the mind, because we have the mind. You have to become angry, you have to become upset, you become sad, very sorry, something like that. So they say, if you don't have the mind, no such thing will arise. So you can live happily all the time. So what they do is, after attaining the fifth jhana, they again undertake the meditation again, and we call it asanya, viraga meditation. So that is that the meditation, without. without the desire, not to get, the asanya. So perception, where do you go? Perception, sanya, we go perception with sanya, no? So they don't like to get the sanya. So sanya associate with all the mind. If there is no sanya, no mind. No? If you have no sanya, no mind. No? So they call it, no, sanya viraga meditation. So if you are successful in that meditation, no, when you die, so that karma, no, will reduce rebirth, and they produce rebirth, no, to become asanya sadda brahma. Without minds, only with bodies. No, the Brahma bodies are very big. No? So they are, no, their body is very, very pleasant with, you know, the no, so they can live very pleasantly actually, but with no mind. No, with no mind. So we? The body is the full body. So not in the body in the chapter 6 we will study about materiality. No, so they have jivita rupa is light materiality. So they also have light. No, they also have light, but no mind. And they can live for 500 war cycles. No, their lifespan is 500 war cycles, very pleasantly. So whatever you wish, the mind can do for you. Your mind can do for you. Okay.
Where is the Mara?
Mara in the sixth, not the sixth. No. The sixth are the celestial realm. So Pranimita Vasavati. No, so they belong to this realm, the Mara. And not like we have the bad peoples in the human realm. So we also have bad celestial beings. So he is the leader of those bad people, the celestial being. Okay, now we have one more. No? So, no, not yet. All right? Lifespan, I think. What is the next topic? What's that? After this, what? Okay. So we go to four modes of conceiving. So we already finished. No? Two chatuka finish. So this is the third group of four modes of conceiving. Oh, not yet. Oh, yes, I think it's all right. No, not yet. Only the third one is four kinds of karma. No, four kinds of karma. So this is very, no, just a little more. So there are four modes of the conceiving. So they said one is Andhaja Patisanti, egg-born rebirth, conceiving in the eggshell. So like the chickens, no, like the ducks and the birds, no, they are born by this egg-born rebirth. No, they are conceived in the egg, no, and then they are born from the egg. And then we have Jala Bhuja Patisanti, womb-born rebirth, conceiving in the womb of the mother, human being, dogs, no, the cows, so all these we are born with, no, from the womb. And number three is Samsedaja, no, Samsedaja Patisanti, moisture-born rebirth, conceiving in the hollow of a tree trunk, in a fruit, in a flower, in marsh, in stagnant water, in corpses and carcasses, etc., like flies and mosquitoes. You know that flies, they lay, no, their eggs in these, no, the corpses and the, no, the and carcasses and rotting, rotten meat also there. So they lay their eggs. Their eggs do not have any shell. Not just a little, not the five piece, not just a little 5 piece. And from there, not the maggot comes out. And from the maggots, they have the wings and they become the flies. And how are the mosquitoes born? So mosquitoes, the female mosquito, they lay their eggs in stagnant water. So no, and that's why, no, like in the Singapore and also Malaysia, I think, no, though you belong to the tropical country, no, we suppose you have more mosquito than our country, no, but now you have less mosquito than us, no, because the government, like in Singapore, no, they make it the rule. So no, you don't leave any water without cover. No? So all the pots, all the tubs, no, that you put water should be covered. No? So they don't have stagnant, you should have stagnant water. No? Even in the pond. So maybe in the pond, I do not know how they prevent it. No? Even then the mosquito can lay eggs there. And then they have, from the eggs, what comes out? Lava, do you call it? No, that swim in the water, not lava. So from that, they get the wings and they come up as mosquito. No? And then also the frogs. No, they say the female frog, they lay their eggs in the stagnant water. No, in the ditch, so the stagnant water there. So like the fish and the frog. No, the one female frog, can lay egg up to 3,000 eggs in one, in one time. No, the fish also. No, so some of you have not have the chance to eat the fish eggs. So many eggs there, in that. So they say they can lay eggs up to 3,000. So that means when they try to breed the fish in a pond, they put only 5 female fish and 1 male fish, only that. Then when they get the eggs and they lay the eggs, they like the fish, they give birth to little fish. So many fish are born. No? So it fills up the whole pond with these 5 fish. No? So the animals can grow very rapidly. How about human beings? No? So we are born only about 2-3 years one. A woman will give birth only about after 2 hours, 2 years or 3 years. So that means many the living beings are born as human beings. So most of the living beings are born as in the wolf or boat, as the animal. So we have a lot of animals. Like in the sea, we have the very tiny, the animals, in the sea also. They make the rotten fish, they say they like in Myanmar, we go, we pay ngapi. What do you call in English? So not only salted fish, it is rotten fish actually. they smell very bad actually, but they taste quite good. So the people, they eat that, Even the English teachers, when they come to come and teach, in Myanmar, in the convent school, the Christian school, really. So they also get addicted to this rotten fish. So when they went back to the United Kingdom, so they asked their friend to send to send the rotten fish because they like to eat that also. So when we were young, we also liked it very much, actually. No? Okay. So, where are we? Number four. So this is very interesting. And also here, no, we see, no, in this samsi, the Japanese santi, no, moisture born rebirth, we see, conceiving in the, no, hollow of a tree trunk. So in our, no, the Myanmar history, we have one lady, no, who was born in the, no, in a bamboo. So, no, in the bamboo, when they cut the bamboo, a little baby, no, come out, and then when she was rare, become 16 years old, she was very beautiful. And then, no, they tried to go offer the king at that time. No, king, so her ears very big. So the minister say, oh, she is not qualified to be a queen. So the queen has, no, to refuse her. And then they offer it to the, no, to the prince. The prince take her. And then later on, no, they make the surgical operation. At that time, no, she become very beautiful. No? So we call it Vilubadi. No, she become, later on, she become a queen, actually. So can be reborn like that. No, son are born in the fruit. Some are born in the flower. No, these are. Not so we go do this samsi rija patisanti. And then this fourth one, opa patika. No, opa patika patisanti. Spontaneous rebirth. Rebirth in the form of a fully grown up person. No, about 16 years of age for females and about 18 years of age for males. As if jumping out of, no, from nowhere. So they are born, no, fully as a grown-up person, just like celestial being. No, now all those celestial beings, no, in the higher realms, no, the excluded the. So now these all celestial beings, and then all the Brahmas, and also all the hell denizens are also born, no, the spontaneously. And we also have somebody here, application, we say. And then this andaja, patisanti, no, born from the eggs, no, eggshells. And then jalabuja patisanti, born from the womb. So these two types of patisanti are also collectively called as gabba seyaka patisanti, conceiving in the womb. No, like the hen's egg is also conceived in the womb. And then after that, no, they lay the eggs. So, and then from the eggs, no, the chicken come out. So two times, giving birth two times. So, okay, application, we can read. Now, woeful person in hells are born by way of opa patika, patisanti, not this one, spontaneous rebirth, all hell denizen. And peta, woeful ghost. And asura, demons, are born by either jalabuja, no, womb-born, this is, no, womb-born, jalabuja, prisanti, or also by this opapatika, prisanti. And three, animals, are born by all the four modes of conceiving, all the four modes of conceiving. No, as we have seen, no, the chickens are born, or egg-born. And then the mosquito and the flies, how are they born? They are born by samsi rija prisanti. And then the cows, the cats, they are born from the womb-born prisanti. And also animals are born by this, you know, the spontaneous rebirth. So in the story, during the times of the Buddha, no, there was a monk by the name of Venerable Teksa. And one day, no, his sister offered him a new robe. And he wanted, no, to wear the new robe, but he became sick. So, no, why he was still sick? See, he was still attached to that new robe. Oh, I will wear it after when I become, no? So cure from my disease. But she passed away. No, she passed away. And he became a flea in that robe. No, though remember, no, he is a bhikkhu. No, so bhikkhu, no, they get great merit every day. No, great good karma, we say. But no, at the time of death, if you are clinging, no, to this another robe, you become a flea there. So his companion, Bhikkhu, did not know that he became a flea. So they said, as the Venerable Tesa passed away, now his belongings become Samgika. That means they belong to the Sangha. So we can share with that. So they share among them. You take the bow. This person take the lower rope. I will take the upper rope. And then the flea was shouting, I won't give my rope. I won't give my rope. Don't take it. So they don't hear, no, this box. They don't hear. So not the flea, no, cannot make the sound actually. But the Buddha hear. So he came out. No, he came out from his pre-green chamber. No, pre-green chamber, we say, no, the place he lived. So he stopped them. Now you stop, no, sharing the properties of the, no, Venerable Tesa. You wait for 7 days. Only then, after that, you can share. So after 7 days, this flea passed away. No, so their lifespan is very short, actually. No. So we say, no, the animals can also be born, no, by this spontaneous rebirth, by spontaneous rebirth. And then we have here, no, the human being, first born by opapatika parisanti, there's spontaneous rebirth. At the beginning of the world, and later by either jalabuja parisanti, womb born from the mothers, or samsidija parisanti, so born from the fruit, from the flowers, etc. So, no, the Buddha, so also, no, in his teaching, he described that at the beginning of this world, no, when the world has, no, the good condition for living beings to live, so those Brahmas, no, when they die, no, some of them are born as human beings by spontaneous rebirth. And they can fly at that time, no? They can fly, not just like the Brahma. And then they have body rays also, no? And then they don't need to eat at that time, just like you are the celestial being. But later they found that, no, in the earth, no, they are not like very fragrant, no, these some component of the arts, no, become very so they were interested, so they tried to eat it. Very tasty. So when they not start eating that, so at first, like the Brahma, they don't have the, you know, the sex organs. They don't have any sex organ. So after eating this flavor, the flavor art, they get, you know, the sense organ, you know, the sex organ. So man and woman, so they fell in love. From that they produce children. So they get womb born. You know? Now we have womb born. So we say here, human beings are first born by opapatika prasanthi, and, you know, at the beginning of the world, and later by either jalabuja prasanthi, or sansidija prasanthi. No, sansidija prasanthi. Or as I told you, no, they can be born from the fruit, from the slava, etc. And during the time of the Buddha, no, we have one lady who was born spontaneously. No, so it is in Vaisali country, actually. No, so in the garden, no, in the garden of the princess, they call, no, Vaisali, the Lichvi princess. So, no, a lady was born. No, there's two branch of the mango tree. So at the middle of that, not mango tree, she was born at the age of 16 years. already spontaneously. So the gardener, as she didn't have any clothing, so now he buy clothes not to give the this lady, and he take it not to the palace. So at that time the princes, they rule the country collectively, not just like like the government nowadays. No, they live. No, so every one of them. Oh, she's very beautiful. They like her. They want to get her. But as they cannot share among them, they said, so we make her, no? They call it, at that time, no? It is a very high rank. Nowadays we call prostitute. So at that time, they call her, no? Special appointed by the king, not this lady. So whoever do enjoy with her for one night, you must pay $1,000. No? So they make like that. No? So she's very beautiful. No? As a soul. So now the human being can also be born spontaneously. And the reason she was born, no, spontaneously, she also met the previous Buddha. No? At that time, she even become the bhikkhuni. And then she made the wish, may I be born spontaneously, no, in my next rebirth. So maybe after the bhikkhuni, she was born in the celestial realm. And then during our Buddha's time, she became, no, she was born spontaneously. No? So if you wish to be born spontaneously, you can make a wish. When you perform non-meritorious deeds. Okay, so I think, so we can go on. So all the, no, earthbound devas are born by either Jalabhuja Prisanthi and then Opapatika Prisanthi, no, spontaneous rebirth. And also, no, they are born just like human beings from the mother's womb. No, so like the earthbound deities, they live on trees. Many of them live on trees. So during the Buddha's time, not only the monk cut the branches of the trees. And he didn't know that, no, there was another celestial baby. No, so the also like, no, so what do you call it? The bucket. Put in the, no, put. So and then, you know, they put their child there, no, and then they rock, no, the cradle, no. So the hand that rocks the cradle will rule the world. So, no. So that man, no, when he cut the branch, he also cut the hand of that little child. So not the deva went to the Buddha and told the Buddha, Imam cut his child, he said. So not the Buddha, from that day he made a rule. No, the monks, no, you must not cut the branch of the tree. And you cannot even pluck the leaves. And even the grass, you cannot pull, no, you cannot take out, Sue said. And because, no, some of the deities, no, they don't even have the chance to live on the trees, because the trees already occupied. So they have to live on grass, no. So the Buddha said, you don't do that like that. So, no, they like very low, like we say, earthbound deity, they have to live on grass, not like that. So, okay. So now we get this. Now, lifespans of being. So now, celestial devas and brahmas are all born by spontaneous rebirth. And now we have lifespan. Both persons in the four woeful abodes do not have fixed lifespans. They suffer in woeful states in accordance with their karma. No, their lifespan differs according to their evil deeds. So some are short-lived and some are long-lived. During the Buddha's time, no, let the monk teach, no, the monk I just told you, after expiring, became a flea for 7 days in the new robe, which was offered to him by his sister, and which he was attached to at the time of expiring. And he lived only for 7 days, we see, no? And then Manlika, no, the chief queen of King Kosala, had to suffer in avijit hell only for 7 human days due to an immoral deed that she performed, and then she was reborn in celestial realm for her good deed. And on the other hand, Devadatta is destined to suffer for an aeon, no, very long time, it's called an aeon in hell, for his serious bad karma of causing a chism. No, a chism is a break in the order of bhikkhus. So this Manlika, no, Manlika, the story, her story is quite interesting actually. No, this Manlika and the King Kosala, they have been husband and wife for 700 existences. So, no, if you're husband and wife, if you want to be, no, to be together again in this life, you can perform a tourist deed together and you make your wish. No, make your wish. To be born together. No? So that Manlika, no, in this life, no, she was born as a daughter of a, no, flower, no, plucking person actually, who sowed the flower. So, and the King Kosala, no, so he organized his army, and he went to fight, no, the Raja Graha city, which is ruled by Bimbisara and later on by the Ajatasattu. And he lost, no, he lost in the battle, so he had to run away with a horse. So very far away actually, so, no, he tried to run across and come into the garden there. So when he reached the garden, he was very tired, and he was very thirsty at that time. And the Manlika was plucking the flower on the tree. She was singing. She was singing while she do that. And her song attracted the king, the attention of the king. So the king went, no, below that, under that tree. And Manlika instantly came down. And then he had, you know, she had some drinking water, she offered the king. And then as the king was not perspiring, she was trying to fend the king. So the king fell in love with her. No, because they have already husband and wife, remember? So the king took her and made her his chief queen. No, his chief queen and there. And he is quite, and this lady, no, is quite they have the good wisdom actually. So at one time the king has to compete with the, no, with the his citizen in offering offer the food to the Buddha. Who can offer the better food to the Buddha? So each day, no, the king offer one day, and then the countrymen they offer the next day. So they try to be superior to the other. And then King Kosala could not think of the way how to beat, no, this competition. So Manlika gave him the advice. Now, no, all the food, you make it as grand as possible. And you can use your white elephant. So, no, in coming to the dining room there, no, inviting the Buddha and the Sangha, so put the two, no, white elephant, no, as to the welcoming the Buddha. So the king won actually the competition, and such offering is called asa disa dana. So not the incomparable dana, no, dana. So there, in one the Buddha, there's only one time can arise such offering, and the King Kosala, has that title, to offer asadisa offering. But one day, why the queen, took a bath, in the bathroom, so when she entered the bathroom, a dog also followed her, and then she enjoyed sex with the dog, and when she came out, the dog followed her. They come out together, and then the king was looking from the palace. He could see his queen and the dog came out together. So the king immediately inquired, why you and the dog came out together? So Manika, she lied actually. You have wrong vision. I came up alone, she said. You have the wrong vision. And as the king loved her very much, the king excused her. And so when she died, she was about to die, she remembered this story. So when she died, she was born in Avijja. In spite of performing many meritorious deeds. So at the time of near death is very important. I told you, remember, just like that the Venerable Tiksa. So because attaching to the rope became an animal there. The same thing here. So did she remember this story, so she was born in the Avijja. And the king wanted to know where she was born, as she loved her very much. So she said, I will went to the Buddha to ask it. So he went to the Jetavana monastery. It's in his country, actually, in Sabati city. So when he went to the Buddha knew his intention. So if the Buddha said, your wife is in Avijja, he would be very, very disappointed. Oh, he said, she have done so much good deeds. Why she would be born in the hell? So the Buddha made him to forget to ask that question. So he just talked about the many affairs in the country, and then he went back. Only when he got to the palace, he remembered, I forgot to ask that question. The next day he came again, and the Buddha made him to forget it again. So in that way, 7 days, the Buddha made him to forget it. And only on the 8th day, the Buddha allowed him to ask the question. Because the Buddha already knew that on the 8th day, the Manika escaped from the hell. So the reason is that meritorious deed, great meritorious deed, and very powerful karma. So that karma has a chance to bear result. So try to help him actually. So he died. She died from the Bhopo boat as a Bhopo health denizen, and the good karma bear result. So she was born in Tusitaram. So when the Buddha told, your queen is in Tusitaram. The king was very happy. That should be, she was very wise. She had done many, many those deeds. So now, like Manika, though she was born in Avijja hell, she had to suffer only for 7 days. So it depends on your karma. So just like Devadatta, he committed very heinous in moral deed, trying to break the Sangha order. So this Devadatta would have to to suffer in the Avijja hell for a very long, long time. Because of the karma is very strong, they have to suffer very long time. Okay, the human beings also do not have fixed lifespan. The lifespan rises from 10 years to uncountable years. So they call it asankhya, the uncountable world system is called asankhya. So very, very long, long, long life. And then, forced back to 10 years again. The interim period, when the lifespan of human beings now rises from 10 years to one asankhya, or now from 10 years to uncountable years, and then forced back to 10 years again, is known as antara kappa, no, one antara kappa. In other words, an antara kappa is measured by the time required, you know, by the pendulum of the lifespan of, you know, the generation to swing from a 10-year term to an asankhya term, and back again to 10 years, you know, to 10-year term again. So just like the swinging, you know, the cradle, so from 10 years to, you know, the one asankhya year. Now, 64 such antara kappa, no, this is called an antara kappa. No, remember, antara kappa is very, very long. No? And then the 64 such antara kappa is equal to one asankhya kappa. So, and this asankhya kappa is literally an incalculable cycle, they call it. No? So though we say cycle, it is just, you know, the lifespan, you know, very, very long, very long lifespan. Asankhya means we also call it aeon, you know, an aeon. So the uncountable, you know, the unmeasurable time actually. So an asankhya kappa exceeds the time required to exhaust a big box, a yojana, or 8 miles, each in length, breadth, and height, filled with mustard seeds, and you throw away one seed once only in 100 years. So in 100 years, you just take out one seed, and another 100 years, you take out another seed. So now it will take the longer time, you know, to finish the seed, you know, for this and this asankhya kappa. Asankhya kappa may be taken as an aeon, very, very long time. And 4 asankhya kappas is equal to 1 mahakappa, literally a great cycle. And 1 mahakappa is also known as a world cycle. So here we actually have, you know, already about this. So we see, you know, this is the kappa. No, kappa is the time period is called the kappa. So the ayu kappa is the lifespan, not the lifespan. So they say the lifespan of year of human being. No, they can fall down up to 10 years. So from 10 years, then they will rise again to asankhya, not asankhya years. So incalculable number of years. No, they come. And then again, they fall back again to 10 years. So, you know, that arising kappa and the, you know, what is that? Receding, you know, receding kappa. So, you know, this two is called one antara kappa. One antara kappa. You know, we say, you know, like the next Buddha, Mitya Buddha, you call it. You know, so in so in our literature, we got Aramatiya, no, Aramatiya Buddha, no, actually. So that Aramatiya Buddha, no, will appear in our world again. So when he will appear, if you ask. So no, the answer is the lifespan of human being, no, is receding, no, nowadays. So the Buddha appear when the lifespan of human beings are 100 years. And then after the Buddha passed away, no, they say every 100 years, no, 100 years, the lifespan of human beings will be reduced by 1 year. Now the Buddha has passed away for 2,600 years already. So the lifespan is reduced by 26 years. So 100, you, no, you, the, You know, the subtract 26, you get 74. So the lifespan of human being nowadays is 74 years. No? So it is quite correct, no? Quite correct, I think. No? So, and then it will go on reducing. 1 year, every 100 year, 1 year. So it will go up to 10 years. 10 years, they said. No? So at the 10 year, there would be, no, there will be a great war, killing each other, so very few human beings will be left, no, in the world. So they have, no, great, no, the dependence, no, so we have lived, no, the very badly, so we have very short lifespan. So they start to observe the five precepts. No, the five precepts, then the lifespan increase again. So when the lifespan increased, they say, no, the children of that 10-year person, so they will live for 20 years. And the children of these 20 years people will live 40 years. So if they count double, so it rises very quickly, it might be. So it will rise to, no, the asankhya. Asankhya means uncountable years. So when we come to that, no, our the human lifespan is longer than the celestial lifespan. Celestial lifespan, like actually they say. So and then after we had, no, we attain the asankhya, no, then we reduce again. The lifespan will decrease again. So no, the Buddha can appear when the human lifespan is 100,000 years or the lowest is 100 years. So in this, no, in this range, the Buddha used to appear. Like the when the Anoma Dasi Buddha appear, no? One asankhya and 100,000 years ago. So the age of the lifespan of human beings is 100,000 years, you see. So if the Aramadeya appear at the age of the, when the lifespan is 100,000 years, still you have to wait for one Andarakappa. One Andarakappa. So, no? So it will be very, very long time, so don't wait for it. Now we are having the Buddha's teaching now, also the meditation. So try to, you know, to meditate now to become a sin winner. No, that would be the best. Now we say, not this, the one Andarakappa. So 64 Andarakappa is equal to asankhya, asankhya kappa. So asankhya kappa is, you know, so you can imagine. So it is equal to 64 Andarakappa. So it will be very, very long. So they say 400 kappa, no, 4 asankhya kappa will make up, no, one wall, no, the age of one wall cycle, we call it. So you can lower a little, okay, we come here, from here. So you can do down up to here. No? Up to here, okay, little, okay. So there are 4 asankhya kappa, they say. Now the first one is called, no, the, so what is called here? No? Samvatta. So wall being destroyed. So when our wall is destroyed, no, so it takes, no, one no, samvatta kappa, no, for to be totally destroyed. And then it will remain as destroyed for another one samvatta vata, no, the vata. So that is one asankhya, no, this is asankhya, one asankhya. And then it remains just like this for another, no, one asankhya. And then the world begins to be formed again. So no, to be fully formed, again it takes one asankhya kappa. And then it will remain, no, as fully formed for asankhya kappa. So now we are now in this, no, the asankhya kappa, now we are. And then, no, so that we say, no, the life of, no, the world system is poor asankhya kappa. no, who are Sanghiya Kappa. So, already time is out. So, we can continue tomorrow, the last day. No?
Let's say prayers.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.